Hi, this is Trisha from Interviews from the Edge, and I am talking to Brian Aris Schwager. How are you doing?
I'm doing good, Trisha. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. I'm glad to be talking to you, dude. You guys are making a comeback, so it's really good to be talking to you. I keep calling it hardcore because you really can't define it. Punk, metal, it's all in there. And that's the main thing, you know, that you guys are hardcore. You come out and you just kill it. I mean, the new album, I felt like you'd been punching me in the face for a few hours, and I loved it.
Very cool. Like we were saying about the punk and the hardcore, it's like for us, the whole concept of the one blood was what's been so special to us about Downset over these years. Is that, you know, we do pull from the punk rock scene, the hardcore scene, the metal scene, and the rap and hip-hop scenes, which are all slightly different scenes when you really break them down. Ray's whole concept of one blood was there should be no division between any scenes. It's all music. We're all humans on this planet. It Downset shows, you know, whether you're going to go home and go in your car and put on Biggie Smalls or Wu-Tang Clan, or you're going to get in your car right after and put Agnostic Front Slayer on. We're all rocking out right here together when Downset's playing. And now it's this whole theory of one blood, which is just uniting different groups of people that may not unite, but they're uniting because our music is bringing them together. And I really like that whole theory, what he has behind that. That's the message. There's no reason for the metal people to be like, oh, that's punk rock, it's not metal enough, or, you know, this is rap, I can't listen to that rap. Because when we do play amongst a lot of other bands that are playing, they may not realize that these real influences of hip-hop, we're mixing Slayer and Boogie Down Productions, or Slayer and Ice Cube, or Slayer, D.I., Black Flag, and Ice Cube. These are things that we listen to on our own time, and we're bringing in the people that listen to that only, but they'll also come listen to Downset. And that's really what the One Blood's about, is just uniting all the different music scenes together through a pure form of art. We're combining true hardcore, raw metal rudiments with hardcore vocals that all of a sudden he can rap a couple of lines, and then he'll go back to the hardcore, go to more of a punk vibe. It's a combination of everyone, the band's ability to know how to play the part. When we're going into the different sections, we're like, oh, okay, we got it. We're in here on the same groove, whether we're making it more Sabbath-y, more metal, or pulling it back to a more hip-hop vibe. We know how to do it as a unit, you know, and that's the beauty of Downset to me, is that we're not trying to do it. We understand each other and how to do it together.
One Blood is so good. You just put that album on, hit play, it gets you in a good mood, you're feeling great. I really like it.
It's a positive record too, you know, and with all this aggression that's in our music, that's what I also really love about what Ray brings. He brings a positivity to a world that needs more positiveness. We're not talking about killing people or going to get girls or get all the money. He's talking about positively upbringing your life, getting control of your life, coming together with your community, avoiding more violent situations that can be avoided. And when you really listen to what he's saying, it's like, whoa, there's depth and consciousness. You know, I've stuck with Ray for these last 20 years. Whenever he writes something, I feel it. I'm really into his lyrical writing.
Yeah. Is there such thing as a hardcore philosopher? Ray's so he's a hardcore philosopher.
We don't call him a vocalist. We always on the records call him a messenger, you know, because he's sending a message. He's not just barking commands or vocals at you.
I agree 100%. But man, I love his voice. Oh, he's got a great voice. It's just, you know, it's so raw. He makes you feel something. When his voice hits you, bam. That's hard to replace. He's got a voice that you can't just throw somebody else in there and they're going to be okay.
Yeah, I believe you can't do that. Yeah. Ray came up with the name Downset and formed the band. And yeah, you can't throw somebody else in there. It's just not going to be Downset.
No, and the message wouldn't be the same.
It's the same as like you're saying with Agnostic Front. You couldn't put someone other than Roger there. It's not possible.
Yeah, exactly. And I talked to Roger and we talked a lot about doing projects. And I talked to Cheetah Chrome too from the Dead Boys. You know, we were talking about the fact that it was about playing. It didn't matter if you made $10. Everybody wanted to go out and fight for a gig. That's all you cared about.
Well, music's an art form, and when you're dealing with all these incredible artists, music, especially with us, it's a release. We have to go do it. I don't want to say it's the drug, but it's the release. We have all this built up. Let's get this out. Let's do something positive with our life, with putting this positive message out.
Mm-hmm.
And like you said, it was never with Downset about the money. Otherwise, we'd have made a lot of different choices and done a lot of different things. We've done this just because I'm going to sit at home and play guitar regardless. I'd just much rather get on the stage with Downset and play in front of people every night. I'm going to play the guitar just to let things out anyways. It's a different way of speaking for me, a different way of releasing emotions, and getting together with a vocalist and lyricist like Rey makes it even more meaningful. We get in this mindset together and put a groove out there with a message, and it does something fulfilling inside of us, outside of fulfilling the community, to bring people that are into the same thing together and make people aware of different social and political, just a lot of different topics that they should be talking about. You know, it's political in its own way.
You have done all 5 albums, right?
Yeah, me and Rey Oropeza have done all 5 records. And then with our current lineup, James Morris has done 4 of those records on bass. Chris Hamilton is our drummer. This is his second record with us. And I also produced 2 of these records.
Wow, that's really cool. Have you done production for other bands?
I've done some local hardcore bands in L.A., some local underground hip-hop bands also from Los Angeles. And then I did write a couple songs and produce a song for Terry B. for Tura Satana. I dabble here and there, you know, but I mainly work on a lot of different stuff that I'm doing with Downset. You know, since Royce stopped producing the project in 2000, you know, I've been working with bands, and Rey really liked the sound I was getting. He's like, you should just continue this with what we're doing. So we have a very comfortable relationship inside and outside the studio, so when it's time to record vocals and stuff, he trusts me, and we work together real good to get it down.
You get each other.
Yeah, we're friends, you know, and that's really, for this record, what we saw as the most important thing was just getting our friendship solid first. Because this was like an 8-year process in this record. And when we did the Universal record, we had Chris Lee, our original drummer, and we had Rico Villasenor Bellas. He did the 1 album on bass with us because James Morris, due to just family stuff and a lot of stuff, just wasn't able to do the band at the time. And it's always been James's gig, you know, but we just wanted to keep pushing on with the band.
Mm-hmm.
When we did all this and we went on tour with Linkin Park, Korn, Ghostface Killer from Wu-Tang, mm-hmm. We played shows with Anthrax, We Are Tribe on that record. And when we were done with all of that, that was during the time from like the end of 2003 through 2005. And in the end of 2005, we started working on the One Blood record, and the lineup we had sort of fell apart to where we didn't really have a band, and we just kept working on it.
Can I ask you a question? How do you fall apart to the point where you no longer have a band when you're in the middle of a creative process?
I think you fall apart in the middle of creating because, you know, we didn't really have a record label at the time, and that means that we were self-supplying our funds. And, you know, some people in the band at that point, you know, our drummer had 2 children, and it just wasn't making sense for everybody at the time, because when we started Downset, when we got signed to Mercury Records, I wasn't even 18 years old.
You were kids, yeah. You didn't have any obligations.
We were kids, and, you know, we never did it for money, and we don't do it for money right now. But when we're doing that and can't work other jobs and everyone can do their part to get it done, then it just became hard and it sort of fizzed away, not out of anything other than life tearing it apart.
And I think that really is the hardest thing for the creative process, so many people being pulled in different directions.
Yeah, I started doing this when I was 17, and now I'm 40 years old. You know, it's been a long ride. With Downset, with this lineup right here, me and James and Rey have been frontline 90% of this whole time. You know, different people have come and gone. You know, and Chris Hamilton is being, you know, his second record he's done with us, and he's such a great drummer. Mm-hmm. It's like, in my mind, this is the best lineup. I'm not just saying it because it's the current lineup. This is the lineup that I wish would have happened before we had to check your people. You got the best players and what they're doing. We musically connect. We don't really need outside anybody to try to help guide us or anything. We know what we're doing. The like this whole record that we did, The One Blood, we were just influenced by ourselves. We weren't trying to go look anywhere, be anything else. We're like, we're going to do this. Let's just do what we do. Let it come natural. And that's it. Because otherwise, there's no reason to doing this. We're not trying to reinvent the wheel here. We're just trying to do another painting, you know, and that's what everybody liked, you know, is our art to begin with.
You know what? I was going to tell you, dude, I love this album. You can tell that there's a chemistry there. It is such a good amalgamation of everything you guys have put together over the years, but it's still got that raw power to it. It's hard to believe you guys have been together this long and you can still punch out something like that, because a lot of times you can tell the guys are just getting bored. They're getting bored with themselves. They're doing the same things over and over. There had to be something that happened with the chemistry with you guys. It is a great album, and I love listening to it.
This album probably means the most out of all of our records to me, you know, and it was from so many different aspects that I took on the record. From this, the first record that I actually, like at a professional level, that I engineered anything on. Mm-hmm. So I had a lot to do with the sound of it, you know, the writing of it, and just the topics that Rey decided to write his lyrics about on this. And because we lived in Los Angeles again for an 8-year period, which has been the first time since our first record that we really resided in LA for over a year, 2 years. I think when you check your people, we were 2 years. But it brought a real Los Angeles vibe back to his lyric writing. And like you're saying, like to come back 20 plus years later and we found something that we actually found when we were teenagers, we just found it naturally again. It really feels good and it's cool. We just landed back in Los Angeles and hung out with our crews, our families, our old friends, and everything falls back into place of when we started this.
Yeah, you can really hear that. I mean, you guys are just so on point with each other, and man, I love the power of this album. It's just, it's a badass record. I love it.
We were really trying, like, chronologically, this being our fifth record, like a goal me and Rey also had was that this would chronologically be like our third record. You know, like if it fell in place, it would have been in between Dead Language and Check Your People. Because mm-hmm. we really went back and listened to our first two records and tried to understand what even gave us this gift of an opportunity to play music for all these years.
And you found Downset again.
Yeah, we just realized, you know, we don't have to try to do this or that, or we're now friends with the Deftones and POD and Linkin Park, and they're friends, you know, they're not just, you know, we're friends with Madball. I'm still friends with Amy Paul from Pantera, and I know Phil, I mean, we know, we're friends with the whole music scene. We've been there, done it, met them. It doesn't mean we had to let anybody influence us to change what we were because we're for friendships, you know, and right. We realized that, like, okay, let's just do what we did. And not playing shows too for a long time allowed us to do that because we weren't being influenced by anything other than just hanging out together.
Right.
It really paid off in that way.
That's really cool. And are you guys going on the road?
We're trying to figure it all out right now. We're trying to plan some kind of United States tour. And, you know, we have, obviously, like every other band, we're trying to figure it out business-wise too. Our wish list, of course, be get out there with Lamb of God. We know they're going to the studio, and as of early next year, they're going to start touring again. And that would be our goal, to step to the next level of Downset. We believe we've played with pretty much all these massive acts that are at the top of their echelons, besides Lamb of God, and we'd love to get out there and rock the same stage with them and hit their crowd with a big groove that's just different.
Well, I want to thank you so much for joining me tonight, Brian, and I can't wait to see you guys when you come to Atlanta. You're going to have a spot for me, right?
Yeah, we'll have a spot for you for sure, and hopefully we're going to get out to Atlanta before the end of 2014. It's definitely on the list.
You make sure you guys get out and see us soon, and I want to congratulate you on the new record.
Okay, thank you.
All right. I'll talk to you later, dude.
All right, see you. Take care.
Okay, you too. Bye.